Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here. Did you hear it? Because a lot of you have been telling me on Twitter and on YouTube in the comments section that you could hear it. If you didn't already, I think you're about to. So this week's story stuff for the Season of the Splicer was great. We had Sate 14 lore and the Elixni perspective of the Crusades he conducted against them. I've got a video about that if you missed it. We saw a whole bunch of stuff about the sabotage in the Elixni Quarter and how it impacted the relations between the Elixni and humanity even further. Again, I have a video on that for you. We also got some insight into Lakshmi's provocations and political ramifications that might rise from those actions. Again, the video related to that is going to be coming tomorrow, actually. Not up today. Not up right now. For today, though, we need to talk about the cheeky little lore nugget that was dropped into the seasonal story that has huge and terrifying implications. Go ahead and take a listen to this dialogue from Lakshmi from the end of the story quest this week.
Have you heard the song of the people echoing through the city? Rise up as one. March toward the sun.
Did you hear it? If you didn't, allow me to refresh your memory.
I'm on the moon. It's made of cheese.
As one, march toward the sun.
For those of you that have been keeping up with this subplot over the last few years, you're starting to understand how terrifying this is. For those of you that are missing context, allow me to explain. So our enemy Savathun, the Witch Queen, is a hive god of deception and trickery. She has a great many tools that help her expand her power, and Savathun's song is assumed to be one of them. The song is, according to Eris, a viral chant that cannot be unheard. The song doesn't have lyrics per se, but it does have a tune. It kind of goes like this. Okay, so what's so bad about Savathun's song? It can't be unheard. Okay, that's pretty bad. I mean, so what? I've heard about like 20,000 songs online and they're all earworms and I can't unhear any of them. They're nothing more than annoying. Except for Rick Astley, Never Gonna Give You Up. I mean, that one's just classics. The difference is that Savathun's song is a tool being used by a hive god who has previously dabbled greatly in things such as mind control. I think there's a few differing, terrible levels of awfulness that could be at play here. The first of which is just that we have a terrible earworm. The second and third levels are truly terrifying, though. I'm going to term these levels of control as subliminal suggestive control and full Galran, for reasons that I'm sure are obvious to some of you. It might simply be the case that people are being subtly directed whenever they hear the song to conduct certain actions or act in certain ways, and this might explain why some of the people of the city who have been hearing the song now are acting so, well, violent against the Elixni. It might make them more suggestible to the FWC's calls for action. The scarier full Galran possibility is the complete and total control of anyone who hears the song. And this isn't out of the question, of course, because Savathun has controlled Galran using a viral language implanted within the Crown of Sorrows. Not that that's anywhere. Oh, wait, no. Osiris brought it back to the tower. Anyway, yeah, not that that's probably going to be related to this at all. You have an idea of why this stuff is so scary. So, yeah, terrifying. I've already gone ahead and covered a whole bunch of possibilities of what was going on before, but now it's a little bit different. And the reason it's a little bit different is because of the scale. Before, things were honestly looking pretty bad, because a lot of the top brass had heard the song. You know, you had Crow humming the tune as of last season, we had Saint 14 and Shax exposed to it about a year ago, Eris and the Drifter were exposed to it in the Season of Arrivals, we have been exposed to it over and over and over and over and over again. some very powerful guardians have been exposed to this song, and that's certainly not good. But this is different now. Lakshmi states that this song is echoing through the city. If Savathun's song provides her with even a modicum of control or insight over those that hear it, then we may be well and truly screwed. Individual guardians we might be able to contain and deal with, but if the entire city is in Savathun's thrall, even if it's only temporarily or to a limited extent, there's still a huge degree of damage that she could do. From an uprising in the city to the complete enslavement of its population to something even as simple as trapping everyone who's heard the song in a deep slumber. Or maybe just hearing the song means that at her whim you can all die, but I don't think that's quite Savathun's style. The possibilities for what could be accomplished here are limitless and a little terrifying. Mainly, it's terrifying because we have no idea what the limits might be. However, there is a little clue as to how the song might have entered the city more widely, thanks to a report from our favorite hidden agent Arnor. This report can be found in the Deicide Lore tab, which reads as follows. Encoded private ping via hidden proxy router. Ikora, thought you'd want to see this. It presents as binary in our systems, but something is splicing hashes in. I pulled it from the tower's Nexus ISO feeds. It's all over FWC networks and elsewhere. My guess is the lettering indicates some kind of audible tone code, but I haven't listened to it. One of my subordinates has isolated minor pitch fluctuations represented here as hash. These are foreign elements to otherwise normal binary code. See attached report for archival information on binary code. Arnor. So here's the thing, that binary looks like a load of gibberish, and if you translate it, it comes out still as gibberish. Until you realize that those aren't letters attempting to form a word, those are letters designating notes in a song. Savathun's song is being spread throughout the city on the future war cult feeds at incredible speed, and it's cycling through binary that is repeating the song. Great. Just phenomenal. Fantastic. Yeah, if this does evolve beyond a simple earworm into something more potent, I now fear that we may be in the great clutches of Savathun already, and if she can assert even a modicum of control with the use of the song, then we are surely in grave peril. Perhaps it's strangely enough going to be the case that Arnor, who has not listened to the song, is actually going to be one of the major characters we meet in Witch Queen, because she's one of the only people who's probably not corrupted, and I can imagine that Arnor is going to be very important for the sake of getting everyone out of that. It'd be a really cool way to introduce her as a character into the mainstream of the story out of the lore, but then again, it's also one of these things where you could be looking at some of the other characters in the tower who haven't heard it yet. I'm pretty sure that list includes Zavala and Ikora, so you know, maybe we could actually get the majority of the Vanguard still on our side. It's not clear whatsoever, but this is bad. This is really bad. And bravo, Bungie, you brilliant, devious people. Gah! Anyway, yeah, that's just sort of catching you all up on why that's bad and why the song of our people is not the song of our people, and why you shouldn't be singing it. I hope you enjoyed the video. I know this one is a little bit more brief, but we should have content coming out for you over the rest of the week, and that's very exciting. So, if you are looking forward to that, go ahead and leave a like and let me know in the comments section down below, which is, of course, as per usual, open to all of you. You can also make sure that you catch that content by hitting subscribe and the bell next to subscribe to turn on those email notifications. You get that jazz. In the meantime, though, as per usual, know that your viewership, as always, is quite enough for me. And my name has been, my name is Bife. Purudasya ad Astra. I'll see you, Starside.